There has been a lot of talk lately about the real estate bubble. And a lot of folks are asking the question, when it is going to burst? Well, they're saying that the market just can't sustain this level of growth and appreciation much longer. And I hear them say that it is inevitable that it must come crashing down soon. Now people are worried. They don't think it can last, that whatever goes up must come down. These folks have been conditioned to believe what they believe most likely from the experience of the stock market bubble of 2000 and maybe the 1990s, when the real estate market was hit hard in many large metropolitan areas across the country. It's human nature to feel this way. We all know the saying, or the 80s tune for you big hair folks, once bitten, twice shy. Or what about, all good things must come to an end? It's how we react to almost everything that affects our well-being and general safety. It's a subconscious reaction at the gut level. Now, just like in the stock market, there are bulls and bears. Bulls are typically more optimistic about the market and expect it to go up. And bears are generally more pessimistic and expect the market to go down. They will always be there to provide free advice and expert consulting. Remember though, who you decide to listen to will certainly have an effect on your decision making and ultimately your success. Well, I'm here to say that there is no reason to think that it is a real estate bubble. There never was a real estate bubble. It's a complete and utter fallacy. Now, how can I say that, you ask? I can say that because the real estate market, it is a reality. It is in reality a wave. It is a cycle and was just happened to be riding the big swells of the crest of this long, consistent and fairly predictable pattern. There is no doubt that real estate has been a rock solid investment for decades and will continue to be for the foreseeable future for many reasons that I would like to demonstrate here and now. Because you, as a real estate owner and investor, must be able to move forward with confidence when deciding which project and properties you want to buy or sell or invest in. But first, what is a bubble? In terms of economics and markets, the best definition is probably something along the lines of an isolated or ephemeral. The best example and the one foremost in the minds of us all is the stock market tech bubble of 1999 and 2000. We all rushed into the tech stocks and the stock market was in general as we saw the dot-com millionaires being made. Now, Y2K was also a big factor in the tech bubble. People were buying new systems at an unprecedented rate in order to prepare for doomsday. People were also buying consumable goods to stock up for the dreadful event that never came. So what was holding up or supporting the irrational exuberance, as Alan Greenspan characterized it? Well, we learned soon afterward, not much. It was an isolated, temporary incident that had little support from the other conditions. It was indeed like a bubble that bursted. And it has had little support since then. Historically speaking, after the stock market crash of 1929 and 1987, it took decades for the market to recover, although it did eventually recover. Just look at the Dow average and the S&P average. See the pattern of recovery. You can be sure that a slow, steady rise for stocks is in progress. Now back to real estate. Let me explain why this is not a bubble. Real estate is a cyclic. Real estate has had its ups and downs over the years, but it is generally stable with no drastic swings per se. If you were to look at the cycles on a chart, you would see a clear pattern of gently rolling swells. This pattern is consistent across cities, across region, across counties, and all across United States, although slightly varied in degree. In addition, the cycles tend to favor the ups rather than the downs. It is not uncommon to see large cycles of appreciation and much smaller downward cycles. In other words, the current double-digit growth we have all come to know and love in recent years will likely be followed by downturns of single-digit declines. It's like taking two steps forward and one step back. Now, in the big picture, you will still be further ahead than when you started. You may see slower growth, but it will still be a growth. Real estate these days is a basic necessity. People need to live somewhere safe. They need a roof over their head and their children's heads. Like food and clothing, we must have a home. People don't need stocks or bonds or gold or diamonds or jewelry. Therefore, you can be sure that whether the market is high or low in growth, whether interest rates are up or down, people will be buying, renting, leasing, investing, and selling in homes. It is as perennial as the years. This real estate wave has been around a while. I don't know when you first realized we were in an up market in real estate, but it has been on a solid upward trend for at least last 7 to 8 years. It didn't just happen yesterday. And of course, like anything else, awareness of the general public is a bit latent and dependent upon the media. It has only been lately that the media has really focused on it and thrust it onto the front page. The old adage, success breeds success, is also true. The momentum will grow as other more traditional investors continue to jump on the bandwagon and pour their money and resources into real estate investment. It tends to create a perpetual self-feeding market that is ideal for more seasoned investors. Real estate is local and regional. It is true that even in today's real estate boom, there are areas in the United States that are not enjoying the high rates of return that others are experiencing. Now, California is a fantastic place to invest. So is Arizona and a host of other places. But the Rust Belt states are not as fortunate. Watch what happens to Florida home values after this horrendous hurricane season. This is because real estate is driven by the primary capitalistic force of supply and demand. Generally speaking, property values increase in areas where the job market is strong and where there are more people moving into than away from. Of course, there are other factors to consider, including interest rates, availability of funding, climate, and government policies. These are all important, and you must be cognizant of their impacts to your strategy. However, it is true, no matter what the rates are or how nice the climate is, people will continue to migrate where there are abundant jobs, a good job market, and affordable housing. If you can just stay just a little bit, slightly ahead of that migration, you will profit immensely. Real estate investing is diverse. You can invest in so many different ways, from foreclosures to pre-foreclosures to bank-owned properties and fix and flips to buy and hold and everything in between. The key to successful real estate investing is to understand the forces, trends, and conditions that are driving the market. Be aware of your surroundings, read articles, and stay on top of industry news. Look in your own area at the job market and forecasts. There is no real estate bubble, but there is a real estate wave. Like any dedicated surfer, when the surf is up, get in the water and catch a wave. But watch for danger, be flexible, and be smart. Invest wisely, and you can prosper in any real estate market. If you are interested in learning more, make sure to join our weekly buyer's webinar by clicking the link down below.